you're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about the new Azure Machine Learning web experience. It's new, it's wonderful, you're going to love it. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to learn about the new Azure Machine Learning web experience. Stephanie, tell us who you are and what you do.
I'm Stephanie Lindsay. I'm a program manager and I work in Azure Machine Learning.
Fantastic. So tell us about the new web experience. Who is it for?
Yeah, we're building a new web experience for data scientists and data engineers to complete their machine learning tasks end-to-end in a productive way. So anything from prepping data all the way to training, evaluating, and deploying their models.
That's amazing. So I feel like with anything that's a new web experience, I feel like we need to see it. Maybe can you give us a little bit of a tour?
I would love to.
All right, let's do that.
Okay, great. If you come to my screen, we're on ml.azure.com. So here I've already signed in with my Azure account. I'm going to select my subscription. It turns out my IT admin has already created a workspace for me. And so I'm just going to select my existing subscription. In my existing workspace that's already set up and created for me, so I can just go ahead and get started.
So it's interesting that you said IT admin, which means like it's a totally different person that's doing this,
That's right. Yeah, we really wanted to, we understand and learn from our customers that different experiences for different personas. So our IT pro may be more focused on setting up the infrastructure, the security, assigning roles, permissions, managing quota. Whereas our data scientists and data engineers, they really want to be focused more on those data science scenarios and have their own place to work for that.
Fantastic. All right, well, let's see what we got.
Okay, so I signed in. Here you see a welcome screen because it's the first time that I've actually signed in.
That's cool.
We really wanted to provide some guidance to our customers, especially if they're new to machine learning. So we really want to guide them through the end-to-end experience from prepping the data all the way to deploying the models. So if I take a quick tour, you can see we have three different authoring experiences, and it's really catering to different skill levels. So I might be someone who is new to machine learning, and I really want to leverage the power of the platform to select the best algorithm for me. Or I might want to use a drag and drop interface because I don't know how to code.
Sure.
So I just want a simple interface to use. Or I might prefer notebooks, which is more of a code-first experience. Now, regardless of the authoring flow that I choose, all my assets are created and placed here in one place. So they're easily discoverable, and I can also share them with other data scientists in my workspace.
That's cool. Yeah, because you don't have to write down, like, where did you put the data? Now it's all
available. Exactly. It's really easy to find. And then I could also go and manage some of my resources in my workspace.
That's awesome.
You know, and if I have multiple workspaces, I could just go in and switch between the two pretty easily.
So is this designed with the idea that there's multiple data scientists working together?
That's right. Okay. We really wanted to make everything easily discoverable because we learned from our customers that data scientists really want a common place to share, review, and reuse the work from others.
Got it.
Yep.
All right, what do we got going on here?
All right, let me show you the notebooks experience. So I'm going to show you the file gallery. Or File Explorer. Mm-hmm. So this is the Azure Machine Learning Gallery. So we want to make it easier for our data scientists to come in and get started. So we have a lot of samples that you could choose from, some how-to tutorials, as well as some quick starting guides.
Sure.
I could also just easily clone this whole folder to my user files.
I see.
So if I click here, I can just clone. Let me collapse this real quick. So here's my user files.
I see.
So you can see I have a bunch of files that I already have. And then you see a bunch of other users in my workspace. So I can go and see what they're working on.
That's cool.
Yeah. So let me go and select a sample real quick. I have a tutorial here that's already ready for me. I just click on it. Here, I'm going to select my notebook virtual machine. So this is really just like my machine that has everything set up for me, and then I can go and run my notebook on it.
And this machine is running in the cloud.
Definitely.
That's cool.
Yeah, for sure. And then if I wanted to, I can just create a new one if I didn't already have one running. So for this one, this is just a sample template, mm-hmm. And obviously I could go replace it and use my own data and train my own models.
That's cool.
But so this is just a template. Let me just show you how to run a cell. So I can just click on here. And then I can just quickly run a cell. And you can see in this particular cell, it's showing me the latest version of the Azure Machine Learning SDK.
So it's like a standard notebook experience, but built in Azure Machine Learning.
Yeah, it's all integrated. Now, if you prefer, you can actually go click out and go to Jupyter directly.
I see, and that will be on Jupyter on that VM.
Yes.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. Yep. Now, I may be someone who's not as comfortable with notebooks, so I might want to use a different authoring flow.
Okay.
So I could switch over here and go to AutoML. So I switch over to AutoML, and I want to quickly create an experiment. So I can do that. I can either create a new data set, or I can select an already existing data set. And here I'm going to go ahead and use my automobile price data.
Got it.
Because I want to train a model that can predict the price of a car based on a certain set of features.
And this is cool because you can have any number of data sets that you've all been working on together.
Yep, that's cool. Right. So I'm going to click Next. Here I'll just make up an experiment name. I'm going to select the column that I want to target, and here I want to really target the price.
Got it.
And then I can select a compute or create an existing or a new compute.
And this is cool because usually, like, you have to scratch like the password somewhere, and then you have to. And now this is all just in the same place.
Exactly.
Cool.
So I'll just click Next. Here I want to choose regression. I have some advanced configuration settings that I want to if I want to go deeper. Click Done. And now it's creating a new run for me.
Got it. And so you really didn't have to do very much other than pick the data and say do the automated machine learning.
Exactly. That's right. And here it's you can see the status. It's actually starting right now. Mm-hmm. But let's flip over and we can choose. I already ran an experiment. So we can, here I see I've run a couple of different experiments and I can see my dashboard. So here some have completed, some are running. Here's the one I just ran.
That's cool.
So we can dive a little bit deeper. I'll just click on this one real quick. And so for here, it ran over 100 different iterations and it found the best model for me. And so quickly I can see that if I wanted to look at all the other trials, I could. And I could explore those a little bit more. But once I'm ready and I'm comfortable with the best model, then I can just click Deploy Best Model. And I'll just give it a name. Oops. Deploy.
That's cool.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like I already have one that's called that. So I'll just change that. So while that's going, that'll take a couple of minutes. But then once it's done, it is actually here on my endpoint. So as coming back to earlier, I can see all of my different data sets, all the different experiments that I run. So I can see the experiments I just kicked off, the models that I just created, as well as the endpoints that I created after I deploy my model.
This is pretty cool. It's like a single place where everything you would ever need to do machine learning lives in the same place.
That's right.
And I think what's even more interesting to me is that you were thinking about the different personas and you organize things in that way too.
That's right.
Which
That's
is
right.
pretty cool.
It's right.
Well, where can people go to find out more about this?
They can just visit ml.azure.com.
Fantastic.
And get started today.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching. We've been learning all about the new Azure Machine Learning web experience. I hope you go to it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.